Dumela Mokgatse. Directors of Proceedings, Honorable Minister Mr. Vincent T. Seretse, Minister of Investment, Trade and Industry, representatives from the Ministry of Finance and Development Planning, representatives from the Bank of Botswana, members of the governance structures of the Botswana Bond Market Association, chairperson and member of the BSE Main Committee, Lieutenant General Debo Masire, fellow BSE board members, Chief Executive Officer of the BSE, Mr. Tseole, and your team, heads and CEOs of parastatal government, parastatals, and other private sector companies, CEOs of BSE listed companies, pension funds, and pension fund managers, trustees, delegates from the SADC region and the continent at large, our reigning Miss Botswana, speakers and panelists, members of the media, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am honored to present the vote of thanks to the Honorable Minister, Mr. Seretse. Mr. Seretse, we've just had a magnificent 50th independence celebrations a week ago, and I believe the preparations for this milestone must have had a toll on you. Nonetheless, you found it fit to soldier on without a break to be part of us today. As such, I would like to express my profound gratitude to you for your patriotism and also for honoring an invitation to a matter which is very close to your heart, that is investment. We are hugely encouraged to have you in our midst, especially being in a ministry that is the custodian of business and doing business in Botswana. This platform has given us a great opportunity to connect with you at close range and tap into your extensive knowledge of issues. Similarly, it has given you the platform to share with us your strategies for growing this sector and also to affirm your commitment to the development of investment, trade, and industry in this economy. As a representative of government, your presence today is testimony of the government's commitment to the growth of the development, to the growth of the domestic capital market, particularly to our vision of enabling Botswana to become a financial services and investment hub. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me also to thank the chairperson of the BSE Main Committee, Lieutenant General Debo Masire, for ushering us into the conference with his official welcome remarks. The general is my colleague in several fora, and both of us are pioneers of national service in our many respective assignments. Interestingly, unlike me, he has retired from formal employment, but his vigor in availing his time and skill for the interest and betterment of the country is commendable and worth applauding. Honorable General, I would also like to express my sincere gratitude to our keynote speaker, Ms. Mary Boitumelo Molefe. In fact, because she's very important in my industry. I would like to also express my sincere gratitude to our keynote speaker, Mary Boitumelo Molefe, the CEO of the BPOPF. We thank you very much to heeding our call and for demonstrating consistent commitment to issues of this market. And we are happy that you are indeed leading from the front as the biggest investor in our domestic economy. Ladies and gentlemen, mine was a very simple task, as they always say, of thanking the Honorable Minister and the previous speakers. Being kind enough and feeling ceremoniously uplifted by our golden jubilee year, I also want to send a word of appreciation to everybody here present and thank them for making this event possible. Notwithstanding, I wish to commend and say that I'm particularly pleased to see how far this market has come, and I'm very humbled to see the direction that the current young leadership of the market is driving this market to. Having been in this investment industry practically all my life, I've witnessed tremendous transformation in the stock exchange landscape and now the bond exchange. Initiatives such as this conference are very important in trying to bridge the knowledge gap, in trying to promote peer education between markets in Africa, and trying to bring the stock exchange closer to its key audience and customers, who in this case are the issuers, potential issuers, and the investors. As a nation, business and government As the nation, business and government are very concerned about the dependence of our economy on government spending, and we are pulling from all ends to make the private sector as the next engine of growth. Similarly, we are working tirelessly to develop and support industries that can diversify this economy and provide alternative sectors that can contribute to the GDP. Fortunately, we have been a conservative and prudent economy, and we are blessed with abundant long-term contractual savings. So my call to all businesses and state-owned entities is that let us reduce the financial burden that is carried by our government, and let us access the abundant capital, like the CEO of the BPOPF was saying, in the bond market to run, grow, and expand our operations. It is one of the best ways that we can utilize domestic financial resources to position the private sector as an equally stronger driver of the economy. With those very, very few words, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to thank you all and